Did you know the most incredible bridges in the world are in China? Since the 80s, the country has been heavily investing in bridge technology. China went from a wannabe to the single most impressive player in the mega bridge construction game. Today, we're going to be exploring the importance of new bridges in China and three of the world's most fantastic mega bridges. Before we continue, share your thoughts with us. Did you know China was the leader in bridge technology? Let us know down in the comments. China's economic development mainly depends on the construction of infrastructure. The country builds bridges, roads, airports, and railways to further its economic growth. These bridges are important because they make transportation more accessible and offer multiple types of transit, including rail, road, and water. They also help with regional integration by connecting different parts of China. As we all know, China is known for its world-renowned construction projects, and the engineering behind the design of famous bridges in China is no different. Bridges have been an integral part of our society for a long time. The suspension bridge in particular has been a popular form of bridge building since the beginning of the Industrial Revolution. The engineers built this type of bridge to carry heavy loads over long distances with less materials than other types of bridges. Suspension bridges are anchored at each end by high towers or pylons, which are connected by cables to a series of vertical wires attached to the deck below. These cables can be made from steel or wire rope and are suspended from their supporting towers. The deck is then hung from these vertical cables and is supported by a series of crossbeams that run along each side perpendicular to the deck. The structural support needed at the ends of the bridge deck is provided by the cables attached to each tower. The technology behind suspension bridges has changed considerably since the first ones were built in the early 1800s. However, they remain more or less as they were initially designed. A long main section from a single point on one side of the river to another on the river, with a smaller section of tunnel to connect the two. But when it comes to China and its relationship to highly technological bridges, things have changed a lot over the years. The country has undergone three different phases in its road to success. First, there was the learning and following stage in the 1980s. Second, tracking and improving in the 1990s. And lastly, the innovative period in the 21st century where new opportunities always arise. China has long been a country of opportunity. A new generation of Chinese entrepreneurs is changing the landscape of China and its impact on the world. They are not only building bridges, but also innovation centers, eco-friendly buildings, and more. China experienced a rapid economic growth rate in the recent years, surpassing Japan as the largest economy in Asia. This was due to an increase in living standards and a significant number of foreign investments coming into China, as they have a long history of working collaboratively within their nations. As China becomes increasingly popular, the government has heavily invested in infrastructure technology. As a result, the country is responsible for building the world's largest bridges, not only in its territory, but all over the world. Let's see some of China's most spectacular mega bridges. 1. The JIAOZHOU Bay Bridge. The JIAOZHOU Bay Bridge, or the Qingdao Bay Bridge, spans the JIAOZHOU Bay and once held the Guinness World Record for the longest bridge over water. However, this title was taken by the Hong Kong Zhuhai Macau Bridge in 2018. The length of the structure, which was opened in 2011, is 41.58 kilometers. Despite being one of the largest bridges in the world, this megastructure has some other cool facts. For instance, this bridge is 8.0 magnitude earthquake resistant, typhoon proof, and vessel impact resistant. Moreover, the ice period for the JIAOZHOU Bay lasts for about 60 days a year. The bridge was built on ice. It'll last a minimum of 100 years, and there are 5,128 punched concrete piles in total. What did you think of this information? For more interesting videos and trivia about mega bridges, be sure to like this video and subscribe to our channel. It means the world to us. The JIAOZHOU Bay Bridge links the two developing areas on either side of the bay and is a key part of China's East Coast strategy. The city of Qingdao was an opening coastal city and one that took on a key role in China's development. There are two ways to get to Huangdao, through a ferry service across JIAOZHOU Bay or being placed on an airplane. Due to increasing levels, the three-ferry service wasn't enough for all the passengers and the cargo. So, finally, the decision was made to add a new ferry. The Qingdao-Lanzhou Expressway starts at the Rixin Bridge and goes to a highway and stands at an impressive 41.48 kilometers. The bridge's construction, which began in 2007, encompassed more than 20,000 people. It took not only a lot of people to take this bridge out of the paper, but also a lot of materials. The construction used 450,000 tons of steel and 2.3 million cubic meters of concrete. Another fun fact is that instead of beginning from one side and expanding all the way to the other, construction started from both ends at the same time and then were connected at the center. The design involves three channel bridges, Kengkau, Red Island, and Dagu Channel, and the construction development went in two phases. The first covered 28.8 kilometers and ended in 2010, and included the wiring in Yellow Island and Red Island. The second phase covered the remaining 12.7 kilometers. It encompassed the road construction on the bridge, and the power supply and distribution, housing, and landscape lighting. Such a challenging job for a bridge. The good thing is that it helps several people every day. It's estimated that more than 30,000 vehicles use the JIAOZHOU Bay Bridge daily. 2. The BEIPANJIANG Bridge. The BEIPANJIANG Bridge is the highest bridge in the world. Not the tallest, but the highest. It spans the BEIPANJIANG River in China. This engineering wonder sits over 564.4 meters above a beautiful valley. One of the reasons this bridge is so high was because the designers had to change the location of this bridge to be higher to avoid caves and cracking in the karst mountains on either side of the valley. With its impressive 1,314 meters in length, the bridge connects the Duj township of Liupanshui in the southwest of China's Guizhou and the Puli township of Zhuanwei in the southwest China's Yunnan province. Completion of the bridge reduced the commute time between the two cities from 4 hours to a little over an hour. The BEIPANJIANG Bridge was completed in 2016 after 3 years of construction. The cost of constructing such a marvel was around $140 million. Upon its opening to the public, people were so curious to see the world's tallest bridge that significant traffic ensued. If you want to see the bridge, remember this. Parking on the bridge is illegal. But don't worry, there's still a lot of parking lots at each end for you to stay and be in awe of the engineering feat. 3. The DANYANG-KUNSHAN Grand Bridge. The DANYANG-KUNSHAN Grand Bridge is a 164.8 kilometer or 102.4 mile bridge between Shanghai and Nanjing, built as a part of a Beijing-Shanghai high-speed railway project. It's one of the longest bridges worldwide and cost over $8 billion to construct. The DANYANG-KUNSHAN Grand Bridge's average height is 100 meters above the ground. In addition to that, the number of parts supporting the bridge is also massive. The Yongcheng Lake section of the bridge is supported over the water by 2,000 pillars and steel cables. Just imagine how many boats and boat trips were necessary to put all that into place. Another thing that many people might not know is that this bridge is a part of the Beijing-Shanghai High-Speed Railway. Its importance resides in the fact that it reduced travel time between Ningbo and Jiaxing from 4 hours to 2 hours. This bridge is definitely an engineering marvel, but above all, it's a testament to China's compromise in building great things following their schedules. The DANYANG-KUNSHAN Grand Bridge only took 4 years to construct. The construction finished in November of 2010, but the bridge opened in June 2011. So, what did you think of these mega bridges? Which one would you like to visit the most? Let us know in the comments section down below. If you want to see more about similar projects, you can watch our video, China's Secret Bridge Construction Technology Shocks the US President. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.